Hi there. In this video, we're going to deep dive into the fonts panel of InDesign, so let's get started. Let's first grab the type tool and make a text box and fill it with some text. Now click the font name and you shall find this filter icon. So click it and you'll find the different filter options. You can filter according to the broad classification of the fonts, for example, sans serif, serif, slab serif, script, and more. If you want to just view the script fonts, click the script icon and you shall find it showing only the script fonts. So let's pick a font from here. Also increase the font size to 30 points. Now I have worked on my document and when I go back to the font selection, I'll find the same script font list. To get the entire list back, please ensure that you go back to the filter option and click the clear all button. And your list of all fonts installed on your computer should be back. Similarly, you can choose to show fonts based on their properties as well. For example, I can choose to show just the fonts that have regular weight, in which case only the fonts that match the attributes of regular weight shall be shown. To show heavyweight fonts, click the heavyweight button and you shall find only the font families that have the heavyweight fonts. So if you scroll through, you might think, didn't we choose heavyweight fonts? Then why do I get to see these lightweight fonts? It's only because at this point, we're seeing the font families that usually start with lightweight fonts and gradually move to heavyweight ones. If you click the family name, it will expand and you shall find a heavyweight font sitting somewhere at the bottom of the list. To clear your selection, either click the clear all button or click the same button, which in this case is heavyweight fonts, and it shall deactivate. Now suppose there are a few fonts that are my favorite and I end up using only these selected few fonts. So won't it be better to have a separate favorite font list? Well, let's make one. If I type in the name of the favorite font, I won't get the option to add it to the favorite list. So let's say one of my favorite fonts is Poppins. So let's type in Poppins. Here, I won't find the option to add this font as my favorite font. To view the option, I'd have to scroll through the list and locate my font. So let's scroll down and there I can see Poppins. And if I look to the right, I can find the hollow star, which is used to add the font to the favorite list. Click it once and it will turn into a solid star. Let's add Museo Sans to the favorite list now. Perfect. Now next time I have to use any of these fonts, all I need to do is go to the fonts menu and click this star icon and all my favorite fonts will be populated. Click the star icon once again and it will clear the selection. Now let's go to one of the fonts and you see this sign which looks like the equal sign. If you click it, it will populate similar fonts. It's a fantastic option, particularly when you're designing a logo, a business card, or a letterhead. This icon that looks like a clock reveals the recently added fonts, and since my InDesign version is part of Adobe's suite subscription, it will show the fonts I activated from font.adobe.com. Similarly, the icon on the right shows all the activated fonts using font.adobe.com. The tab Find More will show you and even activate fonts from font.adobe.com without even leaving this application. Let's type in the name of a font I don't have on my computer. Let's type in adhesive. And it shall show us this font. To activate it, all I need to do is click this cloud icon on the right. The moment I click it, I get this notification asking to confirm if I want to activate this font. So let's hit OK. Let's select our text and update the font to adhesive that we just activated. And you shall find the font sitting in the list. And the cloud icon will now have a tick attached to it, which means it's been activated. So select it. If you go to the recently added list, you'll find the font adhesive sitting there as well. Let's hit clear all. And it's advisable to hit clear all once your task is done because we tend to forget that we've selected one of the filter options. And later, when we try looking for a font, we just can't find it because one of the filters is on and we are not aware of it. These options on the right are nothing but sample text size. Click the smallest A and it shall reduce the sample size. The one in the center is the default sample size. The one on the right with the big A is the largest sample size. In the selected text option, you can type in your text sample to view how it would look with different fonts so as to pick the one you like the most. So next time you come to the fonts panel, don't restrict yourself to just picking a font. Do make use of these fantastic features. Alright guys, that is all for now. I'll take a coffee break and you should too. And I shall see you in the next one in just a moment. Goodbye.